alive! I'm so excited! I'm gonna play the Batman Telltale series! Yeah! Oh my gosh, it's here! We're gonna play Batman Telltale episode freaking one, man! Give me a second, I just gotta get a couple things set up here, and we're gonna get started. Yes! Yes! I'm so excited! Oh my gosh. I am the Bruce Wayne. I am the Bruce Wayne. I'm not very good at doing the Batman voice, but sometimes I guess. Right now I'm too excited to do like a deep voice of Doom. You got a good song station you should use? Alright, man. Well, I'm not going to use it right now, Jacketed Sword, but I'll definitely save it for later, man. What's up, dude? Great to see you. Yeah, link it to me, and I'll save it for later. Yeah, I'm not going to play any music right now because I'm playing a story-based game. So we're not going to be playing some music over that or anything. Batman Telltale games. Oh my gosh. And I remember when they first announced a Batman from Telltale, I was like, no way. No way. I need that game. I am so excited right now. I'm really happy. It sucks that there's only one episode to play right now. That's the only thing that sucks about these games is, you know, you gotta wait like a month, 2 months, 3 months sometimes for the next episode and stuff. But I'm gonna get this started. Jacketed Sword, great to see you, man. Yeah, link it up. And I'll save it for later. Alright, let's get this game on the screen. Bam! Batman, the Telltale series. Oh my gosh. I am so excited right now. I'm so excited. I'm hyped, man. I'm hyped. Alright. Oh, oops. Here we go. Just getting some stuff. Whoa, ouch. Ah, that's loud. Getting some stuff on my screen. I do use 99 lives. Yeah. I posted about it like a week ago in my channel. I actually shared it on Facebook and Twitter too. I just got done explaining I am not going to be playing any music while I play this game. No. yeah, I like 99 lives. They're like, you know, they're like the Monster Cat station except not Monster Cat. Yeah, it's pretty cool. Yeah, I made a post about it about a week ago. I posted about it saying, like, you know, if you're tired of Monster Cat, come check these guys out because they're pretty cool. Titanfall. Alright. Okay. Yeah, no music, man. No music while I play this game. We're going to listen to in-game music. Whoa, oh my gosh. Oh, thanks, man. Right on. I would say thanks to Crush Puppy, but it's his bot that does it. He has his bot set up to host me, so he's not even, like, around or anything. Thanks for the host, Jacket. I'd really appreciate it, man. Alright, let's check out some options and title screen and still checking for DLC. Okay, you do that. Imagine it, like, that'd be crazy. That would suck, though, too. I mean, it'd be cool to have other options, but it would be stupid to see, like, DLC of, like, different skins for the characters and stuff. It would be cool to have them automatically, damn it. I forgot about damn it. I have a talk, damn it. I don't want... Alright. We'll just do that. I didn't think this was gonna be here. I didn't even know. Sorry about that. I gotta put my stupid email and stuff in. You'll be getting viewers from it, but I just did it. Oh yeah, that's cool, man. I know. I do it too, just in case anybody stops by my channel while I'm offline. I don't expect to send viewers to people's, actually, let me check something. I don't expect people to, you know, do it when I host, but I host just in case somebody stops by. Because people do stop by. People do come by my stream when I'm not online looking for me and stuff. And I'm not here, but I'm hosting somebody, and then they can check out whoever I'm hosting, which is pretty cool. I think that's really neat. What's up, Electrolysis? You pulling Angela? That's cool, man. Well, when you come back, awesome, dude. No problem. Persona 3 movie 4. Wait, part 4. Part 4. Persona 3 part 4. All right. I think I have a separate Telltale password, so I'm looking for that. Watching the shit out of that when you get home. Nice. Yeah, I'll probably, like, I mean, I don't know if I'll still be streaming when you finish the show. Because, like, these are usually, like, an hour and a half to 2 hours long or so. Where are you? Maybe I didn't make a separate, thingy. Alright, well, let's try this. Unknown email? Son of a... What? What? So I'm trying to sign in, let's see... Unknown email, that's strange. Did I sign up with a different email? I'll try my other email, I guess. And if not, whatever, I'll just skip this part. Oh, whoops. You've successfully signed into your Telltale account. Okay. Alright. That was my other email. That's strange. I usually use, like, a specific email for video games, and then, you know, other email for personal stuff, and, you know, I have, like, different emails and stuff. Apparently, this was one of the emails I was not expecting it to be, so, no, whatever. You have videos, extras. What's extras? Let's check out extras. Codex, your choices. Crowdplay, I forgot about that. That's multi, that's the local multiplayer, which, wow, that's really cool. That's really neat. It's really too bad they couldn't do it for live streaming, although it does make perfect sense that they couldn't because of the delays and stuff like that. How do I cancel and go back? Go back. Go back. Go back. Go back. Oh my gosh. You finished the new season of Guild Wars 2? Cool. Right on, man. Yeah, like, these Telltale games, each episode are usually an hour and a half to 2 hours long, so it's about the same length of your movie. 10 months after the expo drop. Only took almost a year, pretty much a year. But, you know, whatever. That's cool, it makes sense. You know, they gotta make the content. Codex entries. Am I not? Oh, there we go. Thomas and Martha Wayne, founders of Wayne Enterprises. My parents. Dad was a physician, mom was a philanthropist. They worked tirelessly to help the less fortunate, setting up numerous charities and expending their vast resources to improve the city and its citizens. Murdered in an attempted robbery by a man named as Joe Chill, diseased. He's dead. Murderer of the parents is dead. Alfred Pennyworth, the Wayne family butler. Faithful, patient, ever helpful Alfred. He's been a part of the family my whole life. He raised me when my parents were murdered and guided me when I thought I was lost. He's my butler, my confidante, and the most secret weapon in my arsenal. I like that he thinks of him as that, the most secret weapon in his arsenal. That's pretty cool. I don't think I've ever seen like that mentioned. I haven't read every comic book, though, but that's a pretty awesome description of Alfred, his most secret weapon. That's pretty badass. He complains frequently about my nightly activities, but he's still there to patch me up when I need it. Awesome. 48 good songs. Alright, man. Later, Electrolysis. See you, man. Alright, Jacketed Sword. Bass playlist that you like? Alright, nice. Alright, I have that saved for later. Alright, who else we got here? Harvey Dent, Two-Face. Gotham City District Attorney, mayoral candidate. A new friend in the best district attorney Gotham has seen in years. His political ambitions have always been as big as his ego, and now he's hoping to become mayor. He's got so many great ideas for how to save the city. I think he'll be good for Gotham, but I have to steer him down the right path to get there. He's too easily swayed by anyone with power, regardless of their murky morality. So this is before Two-Face becomes Two-Face. Interesting. They'll probably have him do that throughout the series then, maybe. I didn't even think about, like, I'm not sure what the timeline is on this game, you know? I'm also curious, I wasn't paying a lot of attention to the news and stuff. I wonder who does the voices for these, we'll find out. Yeah, I've got it jacketed. I have it, I have the playlist saved, thank you. Cat burglar. Cat burglar. Crimes, burglary, petty larceny. New criminal on the scene, tied to several recent break-ins. She's effective and doesn't leave many clues behind. Currently, the GCPD has no leads. I wish I knew more about her. James Gordon, Lieutenant GCPD, Major Crimes Unit, Associates Barbara Gordon, daughter. He's a good by-the-book cop in a department that doesn't trust Batman. He was recently tapped to lead the Mayor Major Crime Task Force. An impressive promotion, so he's doing something right. I think he could be a trustworthy and reliable source of info, but he'll need to cultivate that relationship. He's a family man, so he's not willing to take necessary risks on the street. That's fine, I'll take the risks. Alright. Gotham City. Population 10 million people. My goodness gracious. 5 million criminals. Alright. The city is like a living creature. It's always growing outward and upward. The people who live here are survivors. They have to be, and they deserve better than the corruption that infests this place. Arkham Asylum, established November 1921. Gotham City's only maximum security psychiatric hospital for now. Outdated in every way, building is falling apart, equipment is antiquated. I always forget how to say that word, I don't say it enough. And the stats methodology leaves much to be desired. When the Thomas and Martha Wayne Memorial Hospital opens, these patients will finally get the treatment they need. Oh, wow. Wayne Enterprises, established 1870. Damn, the place is old. Sorry, I had to cough real quick. Man, just got done eating some food, so, yeah. Multinational corporation founded by my ancestors, covering all manner of manufacturing and finance. I inherited a majority stake from my father, but I'm not involved in the day-to-day operations. However, the R&D resources have been helpful in pursuing my private interests. Alright, cool. And that's all the ones that are, like, free available right from the start. Right on. Got a little bit of background before starting the game, although we know most of that stuff. But, you know, there was a couple things there that, you know, I have a bad memory. Oh, I love that change from the Batman to Bruce Wayne. I don't think I noticed it when I first booted up the title screen. That's pretty cool. Alright, let's do it. Look at that in the background, how it, like, he switches from Bruce Wayne to Batman. That's so freaking cool, man. Season pass. Alright, whatever. Do I have... available now. Alright, whatever. Bruce Wayne navigates the treacherous waters of Gotham. Politics is a series of shocking allegations surface while Batman confronts Gotham's most notorious crime boss. Alright. More from DC Telltale? Let's see. Wolf Among Us is amazing. I love that game. Alright, let's do it. I'll fix our brightness here. Adjust the sliders so the bat symbol is barely visible. My TV is. It's weird. Alright, we'll see. I kind of want to leave it here, but we'll go with that. What in the hell is this? Select a bat tech color? That's kind of cool! Holy crap! Wow! Wow! Huh. First time I've seen them do something like this. That is pretty neat. Bat tech color determines the look of Batman's gadgets, gear, and UI. That is really neat. Ah, man. I like them all. I'm gonna go with purple. Purple it is. They're all good, though. That's pretty cool. Nice little selection of colors there. Loading screen. Loading. There's a white Batman logo in the bottom right corner, which is behind my profile cutout stuff, so... You cannot see it. It's just a black screen. This is why I hate loading screens, man. They need to put, like, a wallpaper-ish kind of a thing. Something, like an image, you know? These loading screens with just a freaking symbol. Oh, gosh. Every game. It's like every game. It's so rare to see a game with, like, an actual loading screen that's cool to look at, you know? Jeez. Telltale. Pick your story. Play how you want. Reminds me of those books. Those books where you would, like, pick a way to do it and you'd flip the page so-and-so and then the story would be different depending on which page and which choices you made and stuff. City Hall, 8:32 p.m. The guard sits at a desk, reading porn magazines. dirty, filthy porn story. Oh my, holy crap, shot in the freaking face. What a start. Yeah, wow. Wow, was not expecting that. I was expecting to start all boring and slow, and the dude got shot in the face. Wow. That was awesome.
Get it open. On him. You think he's gonna show? Bring the whole goddamn place down.
Stay focused.
We'll be out of here before anyone can stop us.
This reminds me of the beginning of the new Batman movies by Christopher Nolan. was it the first movie or the second one? The one with the Joker. Nah, not Batman Begins, but the second one. The one with Joker in the beginning, the bank robbery. Starts all dark and like action-y, whatever. Boom, sucker. Gordon's already here though. They're prepared.
Get back!
Oh, no! Don't die, Gordon. You still have hundreds of comics to be in.
They're on the 52nd floor. I'm going in.
Hey! Wait! Wait for backup!
Don't need it.
I heard stories, you know.
Well, it's like, let me put subtitles on. I don't know how well the sound is. Let me put subtitles on. I forgot about that. Is it audio video? There we go. Wait. Oh, there we go. We'll try a medium and see how that is.
Send 3 home in an ambulance. The rest in body bags.
No wonder the cops want him dead.
Hey, you ever seen him?
Yeah, Gotham Zoo.
With all the other flying animals.
There's my purple choice. My purple batarang stuff or whatever. Zipline. I'm gonna guess that's a zipline. Yes. Oh, and now I press circle. I didn't even notice that circle button was there. That's awesome. That is a really good, implementation or whatever. I didn't notice the circle. It blended in really well. I've been stuck there forever. I didn't see that. That's funny as hell. Hit the circle button, you freaking idiot. Wow. That is so freaking cool. Oh my gosh. Telltale games just get better and better, man. He woke up! Please, all scarred up and stuff.
You can't keep doing this.
Wow.
I have to. No one else will.
What a transition.
Every drop of blood, everything you've sacrificed. The city is safer now. It's made you a target.
Wow. That was cool.
And people will keep you in the crosshairs until you're shot out of the sky.
They need something to fear.
In the city. They need something to fear.
Shit!
What the hell? Are we doing like flashbacks back and forth and stuff?
Whatever got it. Weird. Don't let it get out.
This is really cool, man. I mean, like, in Telltale games, every new Telltale game I play, it gets better and better. And this is wow. Holy crap. I really look forward to them,
Like a ninja! Bat ninja.
Oh, that's awesome. What am I doing here? Oh, alright. R2? Alright. I got your foot! I've got your foot! Yeah. I'm gonna suck your blood. Wow.
Back to back, circle up!
That's epic. Oh my gosh. This is so cool. Yeah, smoke grenade! Suck it. You got to get your ass beat so hard. He's grappling each one of them. Oh, it's so funny.
We got it, man. Door's almost open.
I've got a batarang, mofo. this is so badass. Oh my god.
I know you're trying to create a myth, but be careful you don't turn into a monster. Sometimes you need a monster.
Oh man, sometimes you need a
come
monster.
Back. Come on!
Wow.
Come on!
Oh crap. Jeez. Oh, whoops. Friggin' Arkham Knight in a Telltale game. Or Arkham, the Batman Arkham games by Telltale. It's so fun. Yeah, oh, this is freaking amazing. Oh, whoops. Oh, I got it. I got it. Nice. I don't know what the hell that is. Oh my gosh. Does he build up like a combo meter and shit? This is so weird. Wow, this is so crazy. It all happens so fast.
Didn't your mother teach you to knock?
What the hell?
Behind you, big boy.
Oh my god. Wow.
Stay where you are! You're under arrest!
Under arrest. I'm the Bruce Wayne, bitches.
To be intimidating, you're succeeding. Criminals are becoming afraid of you, so are the police.
It's a scare tactic, Al. Just a performance.
This is so cool, man. It's all fast, too. Like, it's such fast transitioning. This is nuts.
Without a scratch.
So far. That doesn't belong to you.
I was wondering if we'd cross paths.
You broke the law. Here I am.
Cut the shit. The law. Don't tell me that's why you do all this. Squeeze into a suit, tie on a cape. Most people dressed up like that end up in Arkham.
Gotham needs a hero. Someone to hunt down people like
you. Who's the voice?
So that makes me, what, a villain? Sounds fun. Gotta admit it, though. You give a good chase. One day you might actually catch me.
Tonight.
Don't you know not to corner a wild animal? It's dangerous.
Then let's put you in a cage.
Bring it, Bat.
Messing the Batman up. Oh man, what a dude, he hit a girl. What a bastard. He smashed your goggles. That was awesome. Ah, oh, that sucks. This is so cool, man. Oh my gosh. Ow! I'm getting some bad screenshots, damn it. It's hard to get the action one. That was awesome. Oh my gosh, that's so funny. Boom, sucker! I got you, cat girl. Whew. Were her eyes bleeding? Did she get punched that hard?
Wait! Do not shoot!
Catwoman is dominatrix! She's a badass! He took the thing she stole, I think that was what that was.
Why go to all that trouble for this?
Shit!
A myth can't be killed. You,
this is
however,
so cool. Holy hell.
God damn it!
That's so awesome. You idiot, why'd you shoot the Batman? He's a criminal. what am I doing here? I have no idea what I was doing there. Apparently I somehow hit her. I moved the joystick, but I didn't press anything. I didn't know what I was supposed to do there.
Guess I was wrong about you catching me. Not sure if it was for my sake or yours.
Give up! There's no way out!
Give me some credit.
Give me some credit. Oh, ouch! She scratched his face. She's a badass, dude! Damn! Haha.
Step out of the shadows and be Bruce Wayne tonight.
Oh, that's a much harder fight.
Don't let tombstones be your family legacy.
Well, time to save the city.
Off to be a billionaire. With Harvey Dent signs and shit. Aw, man, what an amazing intro, dude. That was so cool. I love the transitioning, you know, like the flashback kind of stuff.
Thank you.
That was really cool.
Thank you, everyone. A humble district attorney like myself is not used to such a ringing endorsement. Even one who cut Gotham's crime rate in half. For too long, this city has burned with corruption and greed under Mayor Hill's authority. But I promise you, a vote for Harvey Dent is a vote to finally put your foot down. And together, we can stamp out the fire and save our great city.
Here you go, Harvey. Yo, boy.
If only Mr. Wayne, my campaign's largest backer, could have heard that applause, he would...
Well, oh, there he is.
Fashionable and fashionably late, as always.
Yeah, that's what you get for talking smack, boy.
Say hi, Bruce.
Hello. Enjoy my wine. It's expensive. Hi, Bruce.
Hi, Bruce.
Well, I tee him up and he knocks him down. That's how Mr. Wayne
I want to do
business.
The wine one. It's expensive.
Thank
but
you. Thank you again,
I like
everyone,
the
for
Bruce.
Your unwavering support.
Why is the video
together,
game? Tell
we will change.
Should be a movie maker? They could. They should. Well, I like that they do games, though. I like it, because it's an interactive
Wayne,
movie.
Thank
not
you
quite like Heavy Rain or Beyond Two Souls, but kind of like that.
This is the biggest mansion in Gotham, but I don't think you got lost on your way here.
Where were you?
I Where were you? For the brooding billionaire angle?
So the sooner we make nice with the donors, the sooner everyone will leave you alone.
Just wanted to make an entrance.
Congratulations, you almost missed it. You are a pillar of this city and my campaign. I need you here, tuxedoed and shaking hands.
Tuxedo.
No one came here tonight to see me.
They want to see the Bruce Wayne, am I right?
And I can see him just fine from here.
This shouldn't be painful. It's not a kidney stone. It's only a little FaceTime with potential donors. Your face, specifically, with your mouth that's saying,
support Harvey Dent.
We're the grease, they're the wheels. And they're rolling in enough cash and votes to help make Gotham a place for families again.
I just don't like being someone I'm not.
What are you talking about? You are Gotham's golden sun. Let them bask in your radiant glow. This'll help you too, Bruce.
I like Harvey.
Once I've turned the city around as mayor, you'll be a hero for funding my campaign.
Now all I need is a decent slogan. I'm terrible at those.
It always makes me sound like a used car salesman.
Put a dent in crime.
I have not been since before law school. All right. How about a new face for Gotham?
Look at you. It's not half bad. I'm gonna use that. Bruce, I meant what I said. Together, you and me, we change Gotham. A city free from crime, where children can play in the streets again.
That's what I want too, Harvey, but you know how rough it is out there. We have to shake things up to make that happen.
Well, we can start with a few hands, Come on.
So pretty.
Mr. Wayne, I'd like to introduce you to
Bob and Regina Zellerbach. Of course I know these two.
Hello, Bruce.
Regina here is the chairwoman of Wayne Enterprises, and her husband
voted for Mayor Hill last time. I'll admit it, Mr. Wayne. I don't know Mr. Dent from a pothole on Main Street, but I trust your family. If you believe in Dent, we believe in you. After all, whoever you support is a reflection on you.
And we trust someone like you to lead this city to greatness.
Well, I'm flattered, truly, but this night is about getting Harvey Dent elected so he can fix those potholes.
I think I speak for half the room when I say politicians are puppets.
Oh, come on now, Bob. I'm not a politician. I'm a crusader. No strings attached.
Well, he's not a mass crusader.
Families like ours should flock together, you know. Like birds.
I should have picked the,
No,
we can
true.
All make a difference one, but
I read it too late. Golden age of Gotham.
This city's luster faded years ago, Mr. Dent. Look at Gotham now. Murder in the streets, corruption in City Hall, that Cape Bat Freak dealing out vigilante justice like it's the wild goddamn West.
Oh, Bobby, regarding golden age, seems you're getting cranky in yours. There's always hope.
Forgive me for being blunt, but one man can't save this city. And it's a dangerous mentality to think so. That's how you get creeps like this Batman.
Well, I have to say I side with your wife on this, Mr. Zellerbach. Even a spark of hope can light the darkness.
Oh, an idealist with a bank account. He'll be broke before election day.
And I know Bruce would gladly spend every penny he has to fix this city. I don't doubt that for a moment. Don't worry, though. I am not doing this alone. And with Bruce's help, we're replacing the dangerously unsecure Arkham Asylum with a state-of-the-art mental health facility to help Gotham's most at-risk individuals. It will be dedicated to Thomas and Martha Wayne, in the hopes that their fate will never be repeated.
After all your parents did for this city, to be killed in a botched robbery in some alleyway, it was terrible. Truly terrible.
Tragedy like that at such a young age must have been crippling.
If only that deranged man had gotten the right treatment, maybe... I don't like to think about maybes. And I'm sure you don't either.
Well, thank you. I wish my parents could be here speaking with you too.
And thank you, Bruce, for investing in the health of this city's future.
You have our support, Mr. Dent. Go get him.
We're on our way. Not saying I doubted you, but that went better than expected.
It is a night of ringing endorsements.
Oh, well, hello. Harvey Dent, Gotham's next mayor, and eager to know you.
Vicki Vale, not interested, and reporter for the Gotham Gazette.
This is a private
not interested.
Ms. Vale. No,
I'll burn.
Now.
Well, you don't mind if I stay and ask a few questions, do you, Mr. Wayne?
Well, you can ask me whatever you want at the press conference tomorrow.
Actually, I'm here for Mr. Wayne.
No, it's all right. You can stay.
Thanks.
Bruce?
This is quite the social event, Mr. Wayne.
Oh, come on now. So formal. Call me Bruce.
Well, Bruce, you've been going around pleasing everyone tonight. But how are you doing? You should enjoy your own party before all the champagne runs out.
Just between us, politics bore the hell out of me. Too many words, not enough action.
Didn't think you were the type to get his hands dirty.
Oh, you'd be surprised.
Mr. Wayne, you've got something on your collar. Is that blood? Yeah, it looks like...
Oh, this? No, it's nothing. It's just, cut myself shaving.
What, your butler didn't help you this time?
Hey, kidding, kidding.
Do excuse me, Master Bruce.
Butler didn't help you.
Another
say.
Guest has arrived.
Oh, that's great.
I'm sure they'll find the bar.
You may want to greet this one personally, sir.
Oh, they look like some bad boys. Holy shit, Falcone.
Is the Dent campaign soliciting votes from Gotham's biggest crime family?
Falcone's never been convicted of anything except being a businessman who loves this city. Excuse us, Miss Vale.
And what kind of business do you think he's in?
The one that controls enough votes to get me into City Hall. This is the necessary evil of politics, Bruce. It's in the service of a better Gotham, for all of us. Look, at least hear him out before you kick him out. Falcone requested to speak with you directly. Maybe he can change your mind.
Jesus, Harvey, inviting a known criminal to your fundraiser doesn't exactly look good for your squeaky clean image.
Let me worry about that. A word of warning, Bruce? Play nice.
You know, I've been in the market for a new house. Decent walk-up, sky-high ceilings, plenty of room for my cars. I think I'll take it. Though the decor offends my eyes. Man, all flash, no class.
Well, you couldn't afford it.
Yeah, right. Carmine Falcone, thank you for welcoming me into your home. You're a respectable man, I hear.
Bruce Wayne.
I know who you are. The guy is gonna sell me his house.
Gentlemen, perhaps we'll all be more comfortable in the parlor. Follow me, if you will.
You should know, Mr. Falcone, my analysts say we're raising triple what Mayor Hill has... Hey, what's...
Private audience.
Oh, come on, guys. Bruce?
You'll be fine out there, Harvey. I saw plenty of skirts to keep you busy for a few minutes.
Harvey stays with us.
A man's home is his castle. I respect that. Seen and not heard.
Whatever you...
What did I say? Mr. District Attorney here wants to make sure the rules are followed. But in my experience, there's the law, and there's doing what's right. You understand? And I'd rather see Harvey actually help this city instead of just saying he will. The man talks too much, chaps my face with words.
Unlike most people I've met, Harvey actually has integrity. He's trying to make Gotham a better place.
So am I. So are you. Hey, we all carry this city on our broken backs. Might lighten the load if we do so together.
I ain't here to chinwag about politics, Mr. Wayne. Gives me a digestion. I got enough of that as is. So, let's talk relationship. Chalk this for me.
Yeah. What? He wants me to chalk his pull stick?
I can get Harvey the mayor's seat. Or I can pull it out from under.
Chalk your own stick, you frickin' retard.
Whatever happened to being a gracious host? Okay, imagine. This is me. And these are all my friends in Gotham. The businesses, restaurants, clubs, docks, unions, politicians. I make them all move. And I want to keep everything moving if Harvey gets elected. That's why I came here tonight to your lovely home. Hoping to make a new friend. One who can help Mr. Dent see the light. If need be. Between your businesses and mine, I bet we employ half the city.
Yeah, that's not happening.
Hey, this isn't a deal with the devil. You listen to me, kid. I know somewhere inside that tuxedo you understand this situation. Money gets money. The risks, the alliances, the hidden costs. Your father knew which hands to shake. And which to break.
Don't you dare talk about my father.
You're getting worked up over nothing. Hell, I knew him longer than you did. People don't say no to me. Not for long.
Master Bruce, your guests are leaving. I recommend seeing them out. You wouldn't want to be rude.
Heed your butler's advice, kid. Oh, and I'm no longer interested in buying the house. The owner's a prick. And he's gonna get what's coming to him.
Wow, big shit talker, this Falcone guy. Calling the owner of the house breaking. I already told him I wasn't gonna sell it to him. Told him flat out you couldn't afford it. What a conversation. That was pretty cool. Wow. Wow. That was the full intro. Jeez, my gosh. Wait, is it over? Don't tell me that was the whole episode. No, that can't be the whole episode. Better not be. It's gotta be at least like another half hour. That was pretty cool, man. That's pretty cool. I kind of wanted to refuse shaking his hand there in front of the guests, but, you know, we do need Bruce to have an image, a normal professional business image. It's me! Activate Batcave. It's me. Yeah. This is so badass. Holy crap, man. Way to go, Telltale. It's fucking amazing. Wow. Holy crap, dude. I thought the intro was the whole action part, but apparently the intro was like all that. That's crazy. Realm of Shadows. Oh, man. It's so
another
cool.
Another brutal week at Gotham, folks. A string of home invasions rippled through the city's already crime-infested East End. Apparently, the bandits are using stolen GCPD battery rams to force their way in, with breaking and entering incidents up 40% over last year. Remember to keep those front doors locked tonight. And we have breaking news tonight. Five criminals are in custody this evening after a break-in at City Hall. The notorious Batman was on the scene, but failed to secure the stolen items. But the
not all of them. Let's see what she was really after.
Allegations that Dent may have actually been involved in the break-in. Talk about dirty politics. Does Hill's campaign really think these accusations hold any water with the voters? Or will it be perceived as a desperate attempt from a flailing campaign to take
all right, so we got some new profiles here.
Young politicians.
Hamilton Hill, mayor of Gotham City. Exhibit A and what's wrong with this city. Hill should have been thrown out of office years ago, but he's got his hands wrapped around Gotham's government in a death grip. He's been suspected of numerous crimes, but there's never been enough to make any of it stick. He's brought into court, and one day the city will realize it. Harvey's out there doing his best, and hopefully this upcoming election will be the end of Hill's corrupt administration. Yeah, then we got, what is it, Vicky Vale? Hells yeah. Vicky Vale. I thought she was blonde in most of this stuff, but I'm glad to see her dark-haired. Investigative journalist, Gotham Gazette. One of the Gazette's most ambitious and competent reporters. Competent. I've read her stuff. Some of it can be a bit tabloid, but her passion for the truth is undeniable. She's been with the paper for a while, covered all kinds of beats. Someone like that is the kind of access others would kill for. She might even hear more about what's going on in Gotham than I do. One day I may need to find out what she knows. You won the giveaway for Rainbow Six? Congrats, man. You won. Nice. Alright, and then Capone. Capone. He's like Al Capone. That's what it's like. Falcone, right? Falcone. Al Capone. I don't know. Skyline club owner, head of Falcone crime family. The worst kind of gangster. One who tries to mingle with high society. He seems to have his hands in everything, including smuggling, real estate, bribery, and fraud. I could haul him to jail, but he'd walk the next day. I could shut down one operation, but two would pop up in its place. His empire is vast and multi-layered. Finding hard, admissible evidence is required for a conviction. Alright, well, that's all of them.
Mayor Hill's Gotham Beautiful Act takes effect today, making it possible for landlords to evict tenants immediately.
Nearly fell off a building for this?
Stuff on the street, don't worry, it probably isn't anything you did wrong.
And if you can believe it, now you can't even trust the valleys. More on this after the break.
Mayor Hill says he's...
Let's find out what was so important.
Wayne Manor has 7 bedrooms, 2 kitchens, a library, a gymnasium, a basketball court, and a movie theater. And yet I always find you here. In a dark, damp cave. In front of a computer.
I'm more at home here than the rest of the house, you know that.
Then we should build an 8th bedroom down here.
Sure, I can see the headlines now. Bruce Wayne, billionaire, entrepreneur, cave dweller.
Quite an eclectic resume. Did you find out what that, Catwoman tried to steal?
Well, in the process.
What are we looking at?
Let me try a different angle.
Holograms! Yeah, I love holograms.
This is a map of the Eastside Shore.
So cool.
Could mean any number of things. Money, weapons, drugs, everything flows through that port.
Maybe it's where Mayor Hill picks up his dry cleaning.
Can't make sense of it yet. There's still plenty of files to decrypt.
And in the meantime, I saved you what I could.
Thanks, Al.
Yeah, the same couldn't be said for the bar. I had to literally pry Mrs. Zeller back away. But you'll be pleased to hear everyone has left, including Mr. Falcone. Before the game switched from billiards to cutthroat, I'd recommend leaving the fistfights to your alter ego. Bloodstains are much harder to remove from a tuxedo.
Yeah, thanks for the interruption.
And it wasn't for you, Bruce. I was worried I might drink all my good scotch. For the record, your father despised men like Falcone, thought they ruined Gotham's stellar reputation.
Back when it still had one?
It can again, Bruce. Though people like this Catwoman aren't helping. Is she new to town?
Never seen her before. Hopefully she's just a tourist. I'll check the codex.
I want to check real quick if they actually updated her, like, bio or whatever. No, yeah, see, it says the exact same thing. So, yeah, alright, well, whatever.
Not much to find, apparently.
A few burglaries, break-ins. Seems to lay pretty low.
You could learn a thing or two from her. You can't step outside without it ending up in the news lately. As Bruce or Batman.
I don't like being compared to a common criminal.
No, I think you're missing the point. You have to admit you've been drawing a lot of attention to yourself, and not the playboy billionaire buys new yacht kind of attention. Yeah, I don't mean to beat a dead argument, but...
No one's gonna figure it out now. Trust me.
Miss Vale noticed your injuries, so did Mr. Dent. If they put it together with the incident at the mayor's office, it would undo all the long nights and close calls we've endured to get here. You're in the spotlight more than ever. You have to be careful.
I have a job to do, okay? A responsibility to this city. You know why I do this.
For the car, I presume.
Well, the car helps.
Oh, yes, you drive that thing like a bat out of hell.
Old men worry, that's all. It's our gift and our curse.
One more worry for the list.
I thought I saw Oz. It's been, what, 20 years? Last time I saw him, we were in grade school.
Indeed. You two were thick as thieves. Oswald, however, took that role more literally than you.
Dishonorable discharge, illegal boxing matches, arms dealing, prison stints?
That's a criminal grand slam, if I'm using the expression correctly.
Unfortunately, you are.
Oswald claimed he only wanted to catch up, but his behavior following his family's collapse is troubling. Why he's returning now, I haven't the faintest idea.
Do you think he might know something about the break-in? This Catwoman shows up around the same time Oswald comes back to town. Might not be a coincidence.
Oswald's crimes, numerous they may be, are on a much smaller scale than robbing City Hall.
Well, he was always trouble growing up, but...
Wait, is that Cobblepot? I didn't realize that. It took me a little while to think about it.
Used to be close. I'd advise you to be cautious. But I know you can't abandon a good mystery until it's solved.
That's cool. I didn't know they were friends as kids.
When you see what's become of his park, I think you will.
Unless it's like one of those alternate universe kind of things. But that's pretty freaking cool. Here, I'm a billionaire.
Thank you, sir.
Have some money and get yourself drunk some more. Yeah. A burning barrel. Providing warmth for the homeless. And my hands. Because Bruce didn't feel like wearing a jacket here, but for some reason he's cold. Running late, meet you by the statue.
Great.
Stupid cotton pot.
Statue, but no Oz.
This is really pretty. A shopping cart, some dude. Let's go talk to the smoking man. What's up, smoking guy? What you smoking there, buddy? Got some weed?
Hey.
Got some weed, man?
Beat it.
I got a mohawk. Beat it. Screw you, pal. What kind of graffiti we got going on here? Can't even read it. Terrible graffiti. A plaque.
It isn't what it used to be.
Sure isn't. Now it's all thrashed. Could be such a beautiful park, but no. Alright, let's check out the statue. It's a big-headed guy. You have no body. Oh, there you are.
Watch wallet cash.
Ha! Right!
But this goes through you.
Oh, yeah? Let's see you try, buddy. Are we gonna have a little bit of combat here? Just walk away, try and take it. I've got nothing.
What are you waiting for?
I've got nothing.
Sorry, fellas. I've got nothing.
End him!
End him. No, it's alright.
Gentlemen!
He's Cobblepot. Yep.
Keep walking, alright?
This don't concern you, twerp!
You see, that's where you're mistaken.
We're gonna have to have a fight here.
Marlo might not have some catching up
to do. Yep, there it is. Oh, bam.
Think that'll do?
Yeah, look at Oswald. What a badass.
Stay down.
Oh, man. Ouch. Holy, a gun. Uh-oh. Biatch. Oh, man.
Seems to be a nice place.
Quite the disarm. Jeez.
This is my park!
Look at Oswald, man.
You hear that?
Tearing people up. Cool.
Oh, hey, Bruce. You've got a little, good as new. Woo! That was a right little scrap, eh? Nothing kickstarts the system like a dash of adrenaline, eh? Besides, someone needed to deal with the rubber situation here.
You didn't need to take it so far.
Some folks are fine hearing, Bruce. Others don't get the message unless it's beaten into them. Yeah, it's been what? Two
That's
decades.
True. I totally agree with him. Some and people just need it beaten into them, man.
Once that entire time.
That wasn't why I brought you here, mate. Right now, I am trying to recognize the little Bruce I used to run around this place with. Back when it wasn't, you know, like this. This park used to mean something. A place that was safe for kids, for families. People came from all over to visit. Oh, Mom and Dad, they put so much work in here.
Well, those were better days.
That they were, yeah. Thought we'd grow up to be kings, I did. Both of us. This city chews right through people. Mum committed to Arkham. Dad ended it yourself, he did. My family's fortune. There's nothing left, Bruce.
I know. Alfred told me.
It's funny, huh? Same place that ground my family to dust. Gave you the good life. Used to run in the same circles we did. Hobnobbing parties, round-the-world vacations, unlimited potential.
I'm sorry, Oz. No one should have to go through that.
Thanks, Bruce. But we are not the only ones suffering. Good to know you haven't changed, Bruce. You still care about something more than just yourself. Although, I was surprised to see Carmine Falcone at your party last night. Made himself right at home. That oily...
Falcone was an uninvited guest. That's it. Never want to see his face again.
On that, we can agree in earnest. Falcone made a stack of cash and corpses a mile high, ruining families like mine. All he needs is a little push. And it'd be a treat to watch him hit pavement.
Sorry, mate. This reunion got a lot more grim than I planned. Things are gonna be on the upswing soon, though. A revolution is knocking on Gotham's door. And I'm here to let it in. Which brings me to you, Bruce. You see, you throw a rock in any direction, you break a window that Wayne Enterprises owns. As the rich and powerful go, oh, you top Gotham's list. But when my revolution starts, we're gonna smash windows and cross off names all the way down. Like I said, it's not gonna be pretty. It's gonna be beautiful.
I'm not your enemy, Oz.
That remains to be seen, don't it? I've got great affection for you, Bruce. I really do. Which is why I'm warning you. When this whole thing starts, make sure you're on the right side. Good seeing you, Bruce, but I got some rocks to collect. Cheers.
That's pretty cool. It's nice to see Oswald like young and becoming a criminal and stuff. And I think it's cool to know that they were friends too. Like, I didn't know that. I didn't read like every Batman comic book or anything. I don't know if that's an alternate universe thing, but it's probably based on the real thing. I don't know. Everything else seems pretty on the spot. This is so cool. Oh man, nice car. Can I please have your car? Can I please have your car? Oh my god. Goodness.
Mr. Wayne, over here. Right here.
This way.
Bruce.
Good morning, everyone. Morning, Mr. Dent.
Hey, Bruce, you mind if we swap cars?
I mean, mine
is Oswald is Penguin.
Boy, does she have charm.
Oswald,
we didn't bring you all out here to discuss cars, honestly. Now, we're here about Arkham Asylum. Ever since it opened its doors, Arkham has been a breeding ground for the criminally insane. Its methods for rehabilitation, crude. Its security, lacking. Worse still, those who do get out, or God forbid, escape, are even more dangerous than before they went in. Arkham Asylum is a cancer on Gotham. But today, with a sizable contribution from this man here, we break ground on a state-of-the-art mental health care facility. One that will improve the well-being of Gotham and its citizens for years to come. And Mr. Wayne has a few words he'd like to say. Bruce?
My parents loved Gotham. They invested their blood, sweat and tears in this city. You know, when I was 9 years old, my parents took me to see a movie about a hero in a mask. It was a hero who stood up to oppression and defended the people from injustice, no matter the cost. That night, my parents paid the ultimate cost defending me from a man who needed the kind of help this new facility will provide. With this facility and our next mayor, we create a new face for Gotham.
Today, on the anniversary of that fateful night, we dedicate this facility to Thomas and Martha Wayne and usher in a new era of healing for Gotham.
I'm sure you all have plenty of questions about the new hospital, so let's open it up. You first, Miss Vale.
Thank you. With the opening of this new hospital, what does this mean for Arkham Asylum? What happens to the old building?
I think Arkham has only done harm to Gotham. It's made criminals more unstable.
put our citizens in jeopardy. We can do better.
All right, who's up next? You there.
Mr. Wayne, Julia Remark of the Tribune. My sources say you welcomed alleged mob boss Carmine Falcone into your home. You even shook his hand.
Well, I think Mr. Falcone is a voter just like anyone else in this city. He came to learn about Harvey Dent, your next mayor. Next question.
Please keep your questions on topic, people. We're here about the hospital, remember?
But Mr. Wayne, this morning the Globe received evidence of an offshore bank account managed by Carmine Falcone and your father, Thomas Wayne.
What exactly are you implying?
Transactions connected to organized crime, going back years, and continuing to this day. The paper trail ties your family directly to the mob. Care to comment?
And did anyone else receive this evidence?
The Globe, the Gazette, we all did. Mr. Wayne, Mr. Wayne, is all your money dirty?
Is the Wayne family legacy built on lies?
Did you know about this, Bruce?
How long has your family been dealing with Falcone?
Could the allegations be true?
What aren't you telling us?
Does the mob sign Wayne Enterprises paychecks?
All right, this press conference is over.
Mr. Wayne, Mr. Wayne!
How long has your family been dealing with Falcone?
Could the allegations be true?
Did you know about this, Bruce?
What aren't you telling us?
I'm sorry about this, Bruce. I don't know where the hell it's coming from. Damage controls my territory. We'll talk later.
Everyone, please, settle down. I'll be fielding your questions from here on out. Please, let's try to keep this civilized.
Bruce, I've been trying to reach you. The police are inside the manor.
Get out of my house, you sons of bitches. The cops are in his mansion. Why are they in his mansion? What the hell? Falcone is not here. I am not keeping him a prisoner. What's up, police people? Wrecking up my house and
careful.
Stuff. Yeah.
Put it back.
I'm afraid we can't,
lots of money.
Says who?
This warrant. It's not personal. I had the boys turn the lights off, keep a low profile.
I understand. You're just doing your job, Lieutenant.
Trying to. It's hard to be a cop in this city. Every battle's uphill, in the rain, with skates on.
I like that.
Keep an eye on them. Make sure
great.
They only take what they have.
Every battle is uphill, in the rain, with skates on. That's great.
I meant what I said about not personal. We only want files related to Wayne Enterprises. The warrant covers your place, pardon me, places of residence. And any companies you own. Your holdings are extensive.
And what do you expect to find?
That's for our analysts back at the precinct to figure out. I can't comment. It's a valid warrant. I gotta serve it. Mayor Hill signed off on this himself. As long as he's mayor, he calls the shots.
Well, Hill has a history of making his opposition disappear.
Rumors and allegations, Mr. Wayne, that's all. But if they become fact, I'll handcuff him myself, same as any other crook. I don't know how your neck ended up on Mayor Hill's chopping block, but here we are.
Hill knows if I go down, Harvey's campaign goes down too.
That'd be a real shame. Mr. Dent's the only DA I ever trusted to make a conviction stick. As mayor, I think he can finally turn things around for us. For all our sakes, I pray you've got nothing to hide.
What a bunch of bastards, man. They're breaking my stuff, dropping my family portraits. Man, oh man, we should smack these police around. Bitch slap this fool. What have you done? My picture? No. Flashback time, maybe? Yep.
Bruce, stay back!
Take whatever you want!
You don't have to do this.
It's pretty well done. I like how they do the flashback here. The shadows were nice. Oh man, that's messed up. The blood.
Bruce? I didn't mean to interrupt, but...
It's not a problem, really.
Ah, Bruce. First the mayor's office, now Wayne Manor. Gotham continues its streak of break-ins.
Really going for the record, huh?
Listen, Bruce. A scandal surrounding a beloved family like yours captures the public's attention. I can help you get the right kind of attention. Through my connections at the Gazette, I have all kinds of access. I can dig up whatever you need to fight this.
I appreciate the offer, Miss Vale, but trying to say I'm the good guy here...
instantly makes you look bad. I get it. So let me say it for you. The Gazette received this supposed evidence like every other media outlet, and it's all hearsay. Flimsy sources. There isn't a shred of hard proof.
Still, allegations like this, they don't magically appear. Someone is going after my family. After me.
Obviously, the sender didn't identify themselves. We have no idea who it could be. I mean, no one's even done their due diligence on this yet. The press saw the fumble, they grabbed the ball and ran.
Carmine Falcone wants me to be in his pocket. He crashed Harvey's fundraiser and pretty much said, hop in.
Well, maybe he thinks putting a little fear in you will make you jump.
It won't.
By tonight, this scandal will be broadcast to every screen in Gotham. Everyone will be talking about it.
This isn't my first pass through the rumor mill. I know the damage it can do.
Then go on the record. Right here, right now, and stop it. You need to get out ahead of this. Your side is what matters, not wild speculation.
On the record, then.
Whenever you're ready.
Whoever fabricated these lies about my family, they will get what they deserve. Understood?
That's exactly what the people of Gotham need to hear. You're gonna beat this, Bruce. The Waynes always come out on top.
Goodbye, Miss Vale.
I hate to admit it, but everyone smells smoke. A fire is heading this way.
Batman has made plenty of enemies, but my family... we've done nothing but support Gotham, even in its darkest days.
All this on the anniversary of your parents?
It's not a coincidence.
Oh man, it's the anniversary? I didn't even know that.
You should have told me this was coming.
Then find out why he didn't.
Wow. It's pretty messed up. I think it turned out, though, like that Bruce Wayne's father did have connections with Falcone at some point. You know, he didn't want to, but he kind of had to.
A warrant? What the hell's going on? Wait, does this have to do with what the reporters were talking about this morning?
You tell me.
Shh, come on, keep it down. Let's avoid making another scene, shall we? The press is already up my ass as it is. Mayor Hill authorized this?
Yeah. Then the cops raid my house, taking everything related to Wayne Enterprises. Computers, hard drives, files.
Oh, son of a bitch.
You're the goddamn DA, Harvey.
I didn't know about this. I swear. Hill totally blindsided me on this one. God damn it.
Okay, I believe you, Harvey. Mayor Hill's trying to screw us both over with this move.
And then he's made two enemies. I just don't get it. Why would Hill stick his neck out over this? Just to tangle you up in some frivolous investigation? It just doesn't make sense. I mean, what could he possibly hope to accomplish other than a few cheap headlines?
Do you think Falcone could be behind it?
He didn't seem too thrilled after the fundraiser. Oh, God, what a mess. Bruce, I wish I could just make this go away, but I'm not sure if I can. If I get in the way of this investigation, Hill would be able to spin it as a conflict of interest. and that wouldn't be good for either of us. It would jeopardize the entire campaign.
You should probably distance yourself from me.
What? No, no, I can't do that.
Well, you may have to.
Don't say that. You...
There you are.
Hey, you.
Sorry. I got a habit of being
late. Damn, black guy.
No, just glad you made it.
Oh, it's fucking Selena. It has to be Selena Kyle. Yep. That's her. Well, that's Catwoman. Wow. That's awesome. This fucking average dad's girlfriend. Oh my god, that's great. I think we've met.
Election nonsense.
I think we've met before.
That's awesome.
You do look familiar.
Everyone knows who Bruce Wayne is.
Do they?
Pleasure to meet you, Miss...
Kyle. It's a strong grip you've got there. Don't worry. I'm not gonna fall.
Oh, right. Sorry.
Selena's new to town.
That was good.
I've been not
gonna
her
fall.
Introduce
you. Caught her.
You're an excellent.
That was awesome.
Well, if I lose the election, I guess I can drive one of those double-decker tour buses around town.
So, Miss Kyle, what brings you to Gotham?
Business.
Well, let's just hope she stays after what happened last night.
I was mugged. I'm just angry I let that masked freak get away with all my stuff.
I still can't believe I let you walk home alone. I should have called you a car.
Well, that's terrible. Did they catch the guy?
Not yet. But if they don't, I will.
It's probably long gone by now. Whatever that idiot took.
I hope not. These were important materials.
Oh, sensitive?
Very. I don't know how I'm gonna explain this to my client. When things like this happen in my line of work, people tend to overreact.
We should just be thankful you got away with a black eye.
I'm sure your clients will understand.
I doubt it. In my business, people aren't very forgiving. At least I'm not the only one who's taken a beating. That press conference? Oof.
We've got it under control.
Do you?
I'll handle it. Someone at my office has to know what's going on. Excuse me a moment. Hey, it's Harvey.
The standoff. I know who you are. I know who you are. We know who each other is. Oh man, the secret lives we have will stare at each other.
I should fight
and have some sex. Yeah. The real you. Keep quiet. Don't get any ideas. Don't get any ideas. We'll go likewise. That's awesome.
This explains a lot, actually. How you can afford the fancy armor, the toys. Wouldn't Harvey be surprised? Not to mention, everyone in this cafe.
Well, what about her?
Sorry about the black eye.
Yeah, wouldn't people know about her too?
Sorry to hear that.
It's not the first time men's hit me.
I'm not gonna expose.
That's messed up.
Yet.
Oh yeah, because I can't expose you.
I'm curious about something though.
That's weird.
I do what I do for money, but you're Bruce Wayne.
Like, well, you're Catwoman, so.
What's your excuse? I have to. But you. Why take the risk?
I don't need one. I do this because I can.
And I thought you were on some noble crusade against crime. Silly me. You have something that belongs to me.
That choice turned out to be different than I thought it was going to be.
This is not hard for me.
That was a bad
I'm used
choice.
To robbing people, not the one being robbed.
Who hired you to break into the mayor's office?
My clients prefer to remain confidential. They don't know who I am. I don't know who they are.
But you know who I am.
These people I'm working for, they don't screw around. If I fail to deliver that drive, it's going to cost a lot more than money.
Well, looks like you've made your bed.
No, we've made this bed. And I'm not going to lie in it alone. You owe me. If they don't get what they want, there will be consequences. I don't like consequences.
All right, you want my help? You got it. What can I do?
You can give me back the drive.
Not possible.
Listen, I don't have a lot of time. My employer is expecting me to drop it off.
Where?
Just give it back.
The address, now.
No, give me the drive.
You're just going to have to trust me.
I don't do trust. I guess I'm screwed either way. My contact, he'll be expecting a cat, not a bat.
When are you supposed to meet him?
15 minutes ago. Better hurry.
15 minutes ago? What the hell? I gotta go, Harvey.
Tell me.
I have my people working on it. We're gonna straighten everything out.
I feel better already. Sorry, but I've gotta run.
So soon? Aren't you gonna stay for a drink?
Yeah, Bruce. Stay for a drink?
I'd love to, but I've got another appointment and I really don't want to be late for it.
Oh, all right then. Don't forget to change into your suit.
I gotta replay the whole episode just for that one line, because sometimes the responses in these games are not what you think they're gonna be. That was messed up. Damn it.
Alfred, I'm at the warehouse. No sign of Catwoman's contact. It's quiet.
The sound of an ambush. Stay on guard.
This game is pretty bloody, man, when it comes to the action stuff. Like, damn.
This wasn't a handoff. It was a massacre.
How many?
I'd have to count the pieces.
Oh, good lord. Who could have done such a thing?
That's what I'm gonna find out. Gordon, Eastside Docks, Warehouse 133. It's a volatile chemical. Potential psychoactive nerve agent. Vile stuff.
Be very, very careful with that. Who knows what effect it may have?
Have the computer catalog the compound for further analysis.
As you wish.
Nothing left to bury.
Gritty. Wait, items tagged with something can be linked to related items to theorize? Theorize a connection. Oh, interesting. It's kind of cool. Nothing else in here, though? Alright, fine. Bloody remnants of an obliterated human body. Scorch marks. Link the two together. Connect scorch marks, evidence, the exploded remains, crafty theory. What? Oh, here we go. This is kind of cool.
Whoever exploded did so with enough force to obliterate the person standing next to it. But the chemicals themselves were inert. Not explosive.
It's a lot like the detective mode. It's pretty neat. The detective mode from the Arkham games.
I've seen these outfits before. Same mercs that broke into City Hall. The canister exploded, sending shrapnel right through the container door.
For once, I'm glad you arrived after the heist. Your armor wouldn't have protected you against that.
Mm. Looks like a bullet started this.
A normal bullet couldn't have caused that explosion.
Doesn't appear normal. The point of entry's melted. Canisters were stored here. Canisters of what? It's a cop. The force grows thinner every day. Something was here when the explosion occurred.
Rose. I'm not sure who would leave a white rose.
Falcone's,
I don't know the Batman.
Card.
Oh.
He's really busy as a player.
There you
go. Drones hunting. I want to know his every move.
Good thinking, sir.
No.
That bad?
Face slashed.
Gross.
So, not natural causes then.
Like Killer Croc or something? What the hell?
Skyline Club. This man's been badly burned. But the damage seems to originate from inside his skull. What did this?
Ew, what the hell? Use the... Find the bullet! Oh! Okay. I'm finding the bullet. I stuck something in his freaking brain. Oh my gosh. Well, Telltale, they brought Walking Dead into the Batman.
This could have superheated the contents of the canister,
causing the aforementioned boom.
Blood, broken nails, bits of human flesh. Shredded this murk to pieces, barehanded.
God, what would cause someone to do that?
The nerve agent could make them psychotic. Scrap of metal is from the exploded canister, but I need to know what caused the explosion. Someone drove off after the explosion.
now I don't know what the hell. Would I connect to the shrapnel? Probably this though, I guess, maybe.
Find a connection.
The bullet that killed the cop is the same type that blew up the canister.
Well, I'm sure they didn't find that at a local gun store.
It appears military.
Have you put it together?
Yes. Falcone leaving his rose here. This is a message. Dead cops, stolen chemicals. He's making a big move. One of his snipers hit a canister with an incendiary bullet, causing it to superheat and explode. This may have been a distraction or a way of destroying evidence. Cops moved in to stop the theft. Falcone's men gunned him down. Then things turned grim. Possibly due to the psycho.
Then it turned grim.
A cop ripped up a merc's face with his bare hands.
That's crazy.
It was put down. Same sniper, same type of bullet. Looks like Falcone's men got what they wanted and escaped.
Have you located the shooter?
No, but based on two impact trajectories, the canister and the dead cop, the shooter could only have a clear shot from there, there, or there, and would have contaminated himself with the phosphorus residue. Program the skimmers to pick up that signature.
Right away, sir.
Both targets could have been shot from here, but no phosphorus trace.
I like this gadget stuff, it's pretty cool. Hi, Mr. Man. Batman is very cool.
Phosphorus spike. Clear vantage point.
This game is awesome so far. Like, this first episode is so good.
This is the right spot. So where did he go? Trace stops here.
Then he should be nearby.
Found him.
Time to go to work. Make me add your corpse to this graveyard. Falcone, why did he do this?
I ain't telling you nothing! You can't make me talk! I ain't telling you, Jack! You trying to scare a confession out of me? I won't break!
Your bones will.
Oh man, your bones will break. Holy crap. Hells yeah.
True what they said about man. You. You're a freaking animal.
He's picked up a steel pipe. Oh my gosh.
Give me a reason to stop.
Wow.
You know you can bleed to death without ever spilling a drop. All on the inside. Tell me the plan, or I start swinging.
That's insane, man. He's like, you can bleed to death without dropping any blood. Like, what?
Tell me.
The cabwoman supposed to hand over a drive had the container number we needed, but she flaked. So we had to find it ourselves. Container by container. Someone must have heard us. Called the cops. We were told no witnesses.
Why risk open war with the GCPD?
Some kind of chemicals. Falcone wanted them.
What are the chemicals for?
We were paid to steal them, not ask questions.
I start here and keep breaking until you answer.
The chemicals! Some kind of explosive! A weapon! I don't know! Falcone said he'd use them soon!
Used where?
That's all I know! I swear! I told you everything I know! You're an animal! I was just here for a pickup! I swear! You're Batman!
Oh, God.
Jesus Christ. These are cops.
Get an ambulance in here!
I think I need to call the coroner instead. It's Montoya. Hey! Freeze! Don't move!
Stand down, Montoya.
No. Thank God. You was about to kill me.
You want to tell me what the hell this is all about?
I told you he was about to kill me. What are you waiting for? Arrest him.
Falcone was behind this.
Falcone, huh? I thought he'd been a little quiet lately.
Falcone stole a shipment of chemicals. Appears to be a weaponized nerve agent. Causes people to go berserk, turn violent. We need to act before he releases it.
I got a task force on it.
You already have one.
You're taking this too far, Bruce.
I'll get a task force on it. You already have one. That's awesome, man. I think we're near the end of the episode, because of the duration of this, it seems like we're coming pretty close to the end. Like, it'll be over pretty soon.
You assume the persona of a bat, but you're not an animal. You beat that man half to death. Your parents didn't raise you this way. And neither did I.
He's still alive, isn't he?
And in the hospital. Next time, it might be the morgue. Especially now, during this preposterous attack on your family. You must show the world the true nature of a Wayne.
Giving everything to the city and then being murdered for it?
My thoughts exactly. Every time you leave this cave. You're a good man, Bruce. Good. Just like your parents. Don't lose that.
I don't mean to be a doddering old fool on the subject, but as a friend, the burden of advice falls on me.
Trust me, I won't lose my way.
It's quite understandable to stray from the path now and again. So long as you can find your way back. You bury the person, Bruce, but you never bury the memory.
Sometimes I wish I could. That night, that alleyway, it made me who I am. I can't get it out of my head.
That is your gift and your curse. Being Batman can allow you to turn back the tide of treachery that's reached this city's shores, or drown you in its sorrow. When you doubt your fate, remember why you started all this. Remember that boy in the alley.
I won't forget.
Neither will I.
Hmm.
Well, back into the fray again.
Oh, I got little news things. Yeah, thank you for the follow. Cash Money, that name is friggin' funny. Corruption rumors tarnish Wayne family legacy. The Waynes have long been considered one of Gotham's most respected families, but new allegations have tied family patriarch Dr. Thomas Wayne and his wife Martha to the illegal business dealings of the Falcone crime family. If true, it's possible the Wayne family's staggering fortune, estimated to be in the billions, could be seized by authorities pending an investigation into their current business practices. That would be a blow to her heir Bruce Wayne, who has continued his father's practice of using the money for philanthropy. However, Dr. Wayne met a violent end as a victim of a random street crime 2 decades ago. While there has been no comment on the allegations from Wayne, he did hold a private meeting with Falcone crime family head Carmine Falcone at the Wayne family Gotham City mansion, which is only adding to the speculation. He didn't hold a friggin' private meeting. Well, he did, but he didn't. It wasn't like on purpose. Oh, your name's a joke? Yeah, Cash Money. I know, it makes sense. Batman tangles with masked crook up top City Hall. A daring raid on the City Hall office of Mayor Hamilton Hill ended last night with a massive rooftop brawl between Batman and a masked cat burglar the police have dubbed Catwoman. The battle resulted in a heart-stopping plunge off the side of the building, which left Catwoman's fate unclear. However, her team of mercenaries were apprehended by authorities. Neither GCPD nor representative of the Hill administration have revealed what, if anything, was stolen from the mayor's office. Despite the outcome, many have begun to wonder if Batman let the burglar go free. We can't outsource our safety to anonymous people in disguise, said Gotham Police Commissioner Peter Grogan. You can never trust whose side they're really on. Oh my.
Well, looks like that egg finally cracked. And inside, Mayor Hill was hiding more than I could have imagined. This is a complete manifest of Carmine Falcone's criminal organization.
What in the world was Hill doing with all this? Illegal arms dealing, drug running, mob hits, money laundering? Falcone's been involved in everything. And it goes back years.
Do you see Dad's name on any of these documents?
I'll run a search, but so far I don't.
This is it, Alfred. With this proof, we can finally knock out Falcone's organization.
Where would we possibly begin to dismantle it?
This is a police matter.
There's only one cop we can trust to handle this evidence correctly.
Lieutenant Gordon. He could mobilize the entire police force against Falcone.
What about that reporter from the Gazette?
Vicky.
Yes, Ms. Vale. She could release this evidence through proper channels. I suppose it comes down to who you want to help most. Or who you think could do the most good.
Oh, this is cool. I get to pick who I want to go with. I'm going to go with Vicky Vale. Even though I'll probably end up getting her killed. They won't kill her, though. I don't think, anyways. That's pretty interesting. So this is the final decision of episode one. Is my bet. I want to give it to both of them, because Vicky Vale as a reporter could get it out to the public. But if I give it to Gordon in a corrupt police force, like, who knows what can happen there. I'm going to give it to Vicky Vale, man.
Vicky showed faith in him. She cares about the truth. She'll get the story out the way it needs to be told.
A wise decision, sir. We'll attack Falcone on two fronts tonight. Vicky through the media, and Batman
by any means necessary. Whatever Falcone is planning, it ends tonight.
He's a spider, Bruce. Eyes everywhere. A dense web of goons poised to trap you. No one has ever managed to bring him down.
I haven't tried yet.
Alright, cool. Seems we still have a little bit more to go for the end of this episode. They might, because they usually end it like on some really cool part, and that wasn't cool enough to end it yet. So, we'll see, man.
This is big. You drop a bomb like this, there's gonna be fallout.
That not even Falcone can survive.
Why give it to me then? You don't know how much I appreciate it, but you're Wayne. You could have given it to anyone.
I want to turn the entire city against Falcone. The media, the public, the police.
Once this story drops, every single person connected with Falcone will turn their back on him. What this could do for the city, my career, I'm just wondering what the cost is going to be.
Oh, it'll be your life.
Worth it.
You will get killed.
I don't know, Bruce. Falcone doesn't like bad press. If I run this story, I put a price on my head.
Yep,
the
she's a smart
one.
The next
time appears in the media, God, it might be an obituary. Falcone has a way of handling reporters he doesn't like. I could be putting myself in real danger by trying to expose him.
By a bulletproof vest. It's the dress code for reporters here.
Thanks for the tip. But I've held my own so far.
That's pretty damn funny.
I always think...
Oh my gosh.
Crime in this city. It's a hydra. You cut off one criminal's head...
Three more appear in its place. I know.
Unless we kill the beast once and for all. But who's even capable of that? If we don't act fast, that void will be filled by someone far worse. Wouldn't be the first time.
I backed Harvey's campaign for a reason. Fixing Gotham starts at the top.
Politics to the rescue?
For once, I think.
Doubtful. No matter how good-looking he is.
It's a good thing you gave this to me instead of the police. Could end up buried in some evidence locker and not on every screen in Gotham where it belongs.
Public attention. That's what brings down men like Falcone. Not a bullet.
Though after my story runs, he might get that too. I'll be seeing you, Bruce.
Like, I don't want to get her killed, but, I mean, I chose her for a reason.
It's done.
Get that news out there, man.
The drones located Falcone downtown, a place called the Skyline Club.
You have to hit the button to get inside your car. Hit X to drive the car. Okay.
Though you're not dressed for that kind of party.
Well, I can always change in the car.
No way, things transforming? Holy crap. I thought it might. That is so badass, dude. Holy crap. Yeah. Oh, it's epic. It did look kind of like the Batmobile, too. When, like, you look at it normal, you know, it looked kind of Batmobile-ish. That is awesome. I don't think we've ever seen Batman use a car that turned into the Batmobile, though. They upgrade their graphic engine. Yeah, everything. Yeah, I know. Telltale Games, every time they make a new series, it's always better than their previous stuff. So, this one's really good. It's cool as hell.
The drone's cameras and scanning tech are fully functional.
All right. Let's find Falcone.
Modern art, man. Don't tell me there's nothing there. what is Rose sigil? Yep.
The white rose. Falcone's symbol.
A red rose after tonight.
Oh, man. He's gonna make him bloody. That was some trash talk by Batman. He's like, we're gonna make that white rose freaking red with blood.
That's the most heavily guarded door in the building.
Gotta be Falcone's hideout.
Well, it won't be as easy as ringing the doorbell.
Four armed guards. Stealth not an option. I'll put together a plan of attack. Stand by. Couple of options for taking this guy down.
This is freaking cool, man. Wow. What a, wow, this is really neat. You're planning out your battle, like how he's gonna, fight these dudes. It's crazy. I could use the coffee table or the screen. The folding table. Well, you're gonna use the table. I'm kind of curious what the screen would do. I'm gonna use the screen. I'll do that. This is really neat. So I could use the staircase or the marble pillar, and I love marble. Like, marble is awesome. We're gonna use the staircase though, just cause.
This one might be tricky. Any ideas?
I've got it covered, Al.
I love this. I love that you actually get to plan out, like, ahead of how he's gonna fight these dudes. This is awesome.
Bruce, have you formulated your plan of attack?
It's so cool, man. Yep, I've done it. I'm going cool, in. Yeah. Let's do
very
this.
Good,
oh, it's so cool.
Crash his party.
Yeah. It's on now. So awesome. Yeah. Get messed up by Batman. That's so cool. Wow. Easy peasy. For I am the Bruce Wayne. Hear me! Uh-oh, we got more thugs. Ouch. Wow. Oh, that's so cool. Uh-oh. Suckers. How dare you mess with a masked man? Uh-oh. He's got a machine gun. Oh, wow, alright. What an idiot.
Show yourself! You got no goddamn right down here!
Shoots his own man.
I want you.
Man, that was awesome. Oh, yeah, bloody batarang in Falcone's back. That was awesome.
You can't sneak up on me.
I don't need to sneak. That was so badass. That one, or
I'm a respectable businessman.
The fire.
You can't do this to
yes.
Stay down, Falcone. We can end this.
Aww.
You got a lot to learn, kid.
Holy what? Holy crap! Wow. Alright.
Explosives armed!
Finishing blow.
Fire when ready.
Oh man. That's right, Falcone, suck it. That's awesome. Yeah. Don't make me hurt you.
Spare yourself the pain.
Yeah, I've been through worse.
Oh my gosh, sure you have.
The chemicals. Where are they?
Where?
I found your calling card at the docks. The White Rose.
You think I wanted to leave you here?
I thought about shooting the hand,
something
but
reeks about this old thing.
I was being nice. We've done enough damage to this guy.
Still want to play games?
We'll be playing it, couldn't you? Those chemicals are so riled up about. Never mind, alright? But someone is trying to cut me out of the deal because I did not make that mess at the docks.
Then who did?
No, we're done. Gotham's watching now. Go ahead. Give him a show. I'll be walking free by tomorrow morning. Ha! Gotham! Oh, wait!
Oh, I'm totally gonna brutalize this guy. Yeah!
Spill it, Falcone! While you still can.
It's... the weights.
You didn't make me buy it.
Behind all this.
What do you mean?
You really want to take that crap?
We don't kill him, did we? I meant to hurt him, not kill him.
The biggest gangsters in Gotham.
Oh, man. He's not gonna die, God. Is he?
Take him out!
Well, if he does, cool. I don't care. But, I didn't think we would actually kill him. That was awesome. That was so super cool. Yeah. Some of the choices, there's only like two or three choices in this game that makes me, this episode that makes me want to replay it, but that's freaking awesome.
Fire and smoke reportedly be seen from street level. Tonight, the Skyline Club, a high-rise mafia hangout in downtown Gotham, was the arena for a clash between the notorious Batman and alleged mob boss Carmine Falcone, who was brutally wounded in the attack.
All right, so he's wounded.
Though
not dead.
The crime boss getting his is well overdue. Falcone has slipped through the law's grasp for years, but after this dramatic arrest and a stunning exposé by Gazette reporter Vicky Vale, Falcone's going away for a long, long time.
Yeah, brutalized and going away.
Criminal dealings. This brings me to the story everyone is talking about. The Wayne family. For generations, the big W on the Wayne Enterprises Tower was a reassuring sight. You knew that there was something pure at the heart of Gotham. That this city, for all its faults, was built by good people. But with Thomas and Martha's shining reputation called into question, we no longer have such assurances. And even worse, it seems the apple hasn't fallen far from the tree. Gotham's greatest son, Bruce Wayne, seen here shaking hands with Carmine Falcone, may be just as crooked as his parents. In his defense, Wayne fired back, saying,
"Whoever fabricated these lies about my family, they will get what they deserve. Understood?"
In a world where the Waynes, our golden family, are corrupt, who are we left with? Who can Gothamites look up to? The monster Batman? Only time will tell. Meanwhile, we'll keep digging for the truth.
Oh, that's so cool. This is definitely the end here.
Is that the Wayne's time in the sun is ending. This entire cave.
Master Bruce?
Everything I built. I created all of this because I didn't want any more innocent people to die. If Falcone's telling the truth about my parents, then what the hell did we do this for?
Bruce, I...
What have you been hiding from me? Alfred!
Oh, that was awesome. That's the end. That's it. Like, you could tell. That was amazing, dude. Oh my gosh. Yes. Beautiful. Holy crap, this game is so cool, man. Oh, you can share your choices. That's new. Did you stick up for Harvey in front of Falcone? You win 63%. All right, let's see. How do you share? What's the sharing thing? How do I publish it? I don't. Oh, here we go. I don't know. This takes too long for me to want to do it. Like, look at this crap. Loading, whatever. Batman would like to publish my activity. Wow, yes. There we go. Wait. Ah, what? An error? Oh, wait. No, that's right. They disconnected Facebook from PlayStation. I don't even know why that's an option. The last I knew is they disconnected. Well, actually, no. I don't know. There's whatever. It's probably just a server thing. We'll figure it out next time. Alright, so next choice. Did you provide a quote for Vicky? I actually kind of didn't want to do a quote. You and 91% of players chose to control the emerging Wayne story and provided Vicky with the quote. The next time I play, I'm totally going to not give her a quote. Yeah, oh my gosh, this is so cool. Alright. Did you break the dock shooter's arm? You and 50% of players showed mercy in your interrogation of the dock shooter. 50% so far. People have played it. 50%, you know, with the guy's arm. Oh, wow. That's crazy. So the other people broke his arm. That's so cool. I bet, like, most people probably brutalized Falcone. We'll see. Who did you give the data to? You and 30% gave it to Vicky Vale instead of Gordon. Yeah. I just thought it would be better to be public rather than just private with the corrupt police department, you know? It does make sense to give it to Gordon, but, you know. Screw the corrupt police, man. How did Batman deal with Falcone at the end? You and 15% chose to brutalize Falcone. How would people not brutalize him? Dude, oh my gosh. Those crazy people. Dude, I'm gonna see if this one will share, because, like, I want this to share. I'll probably get another error, though. But that was awesome, man. Like, being able to brutalize him, that was so cool. Man, this is so broken. Ugh. Bleh. Dude, come on. Oh my gosh. Jeez, holy hell. Allow. Oh, hey, cool. Alright, what else we got here? Oh, and then it shows all of them. Okay. Oh, share all your choices. Well, hell, why don't they... Son of a... I'd rather share all the choices, son of a bitch. Continue to next time on. Refresh stats. Alright, let's see next time on. Let's check that out. Yeah. Dude, that was amazing. That was so great.
When your parents died, they left me as caretaker of their estate, their son, and their secrets. I would never betray them. Your parents were good people, Bruce, no matter what that thug Falcone told you.
Then swear to me, there's no truth to it.
That scoop you brought me on Falcone helped me more than you could possibly know. I owe you one.
I'm sure Falcone's taken harder beatings in the past. Hopefully this one knocks something useful out of him.
Hell of a view!
Bruce, the Wayne name is toxic. I have to do what's best for my campaign. What's best for Gotham?
I have to distance myself. I will find the truth. Along with anyone who stands in my way.
Get the final four episodes. So yeah, I gotta... Alright. That was really cool. Not now. Not now. Yeah, that preview for the next episode was not very great. But damn, that game was so good. Oh, conversation? What do you mean join the conversation? What's that? What's join the conversation? I'll go to the forums, okay. Got it. Alright, some videos. This is like every cinematic of the game or something? Like I'm... Oh, wait. What is this? Batman Unmasked. Huh. That's cool. Alright. Extras. Do your choices. Codex. I think I missed I had a couple new... Oh, they updated each of these? They updated? Wow. Let's see, so we got some updates. Falcone claimed my family is responsible for the downfall of Gotham, that they were the biggest gangsters of all. He's not to be trusted, but his accusation cannot be ignored either. Wow. I can't seem to scroll down. What the hell? I was able to scroll down before. Now I can't scroll down. That's weird. Let's see. Have Harvey looked into why Mary Hill has seized my assets, but maybe I should be more concerned that his new friend Selina Kyle is the Catwoman. Falcone mentioned some kind of criminal involvement between the Falcones, the Hills, and the Waynes. To what is he referring? It turns out her real name is Selina Kyle, and she's friends with Harvey, but more troubling, she knows I'm Bruce Wayne. This will need to be dealt with soon. These are updates. I was able to point Gordon and Falcone, saving him valuable time. Montoya may not completely trust me yet, but I'll let Gordon to assure. Let's see, she tried to prod me for a quote, claimed to want to help clear my family's name. No deal. Well, I did give her a quote though. That's strange. Oh, this one will scroll down. Alright. Falcone admitted to owning the chemicals and selling them for profit, but said he had no involvement in the Doc heist. Who did is still in question. He also claims my parents were the biggest gangsters in the city. How can that possibly be true? I left him for the cops to deal with now that they have evidence to get him convicted. So long, Falcone. Carmine Falcone and Mayor Hill are the root of the corruption. They claim my family is involved too, but that can't be true. Let's see. Carmine Falcone implicate my family. I think I read them all. It's gotta be a lie. Alright, cool. Nice. Well, that's the end of Telltale's Batman. That was really, really awesome. Thanks for joining me, anybody and everybody that did join me for this. This is really cool. Wow. That was really damn good, man. That was really, really damn good. It was really cool. I liked, the Michonne, the Walking Dead Michonne series, because it was, you know, it was pretty action-packed compared to previous Telltale games that I played. And, you know, including Walking Dead Season 1 and Season 2. Michonne's was really damn crazy. It was freaking cool as hell. And Batman is right up there, you know, with it. It's huge improvements and stuff, and just very nice. Very slick, man. Really cool. Alright. Well, I'm going to end this now. I'm going to end my stream. I don't think I'll come back and play anything else today. I wanted to play this, though. I'm so glad I played this. This is awesome! Oh my gosh, it was so good. So good. What a great game. Alright, man. I'll see you guys later. Have a great night. Thanks so much for hanging out and joining me. Bye-bye.